So you have to mix the resin for 5 to 7 minutes. When it's done, it's going to be a scene of the Hulk smashing Thanos. Then you pour the resin slowly so that any bubbles under any surfaces have a chance to escape. If you pour it quickly, bubbles might get trapped. Obviously gonna have to do another pour because it's a large container and there's not enough resin. So now we're gonna put it in the pressure pot. Harbor Freight Tools, $79. And we're putting this in the pressure pot just to get rid of the bubbles. You can let it set by itself without putting it in the pressure pot, but you'll get bubbles. So the only way to get rid of them is to put it in the pressure pot. So now we tighten it down. Make sure that rubber gasket doesn't have any opportunity to leak air. Then we get our air hose and we put some air in the pressure pot, maximum 60 pounds per square inch, and take a look at the gauge, and when it hits 60, pop the air hose out. Leave it in there for about an hour and it's done. So I didn't record myself turning the cast resin because right now I'm not set up for a camera to record while I'm turning. So basically what I'm doing here is going through all the different grits of sanding so you can see the progression of the cast getting clearer and clearer. So basically I start off with 100 and I go all the way up to 12,000, and I'll spare you every single second. So I'm basically just giving you a few seconds of each grit and showing the progression of it getting clearer and clearer. And the Scotch-Brite preds are really awesome. I wish they had them in lower grades or all the grades actually. So white was the finest, I think that's 12 or 1500. And then I go to the sanding pads and you use those with water. And that reduces the friction and helps it sand, but not sand too aggressively. And the reason I made this project was because I hated the way they portrayed the Hulk in the Infinity movie. I forget if it's Infinity War, Infinity Gauntlet, whatever it is. So I wanted to make a scene of the Hulk basically body slamming Thanos and getting his revenge for everybody that wants to see that. So right here I'm using Plastic X, which is a headlight restorer, and it works fantastic on resin, as you'll see here. It's really fast, it works really fast, and really, really shines it to a brilliant, brilliant shine. And then one of the parts I didn't put in the video either is at the end, I part the resin from the wood that it's glued to. but I didn't put that in there. In the future, I'll show the project from beginning to end. And I don't turn it too fast at this point. I think maybe it's like 700, 800 RPM. And then as you can see, it's super, super, super clear. And if you go back to the beginning of the video, you know, you could barely see through. You couldn't even make out what was in the resin and compared to how it looks now. And at the bottom, that green right here, that's mica powder that makes the resin look like that. Normally, I use just regular food coloring. but I decided to use the mica powder to give it that nice pearly look. And some of my other projects, I just use food coloring and it works just fine. And it's a lot cheaper than alcohol ink. The resin is East Coast resin that I use, and it's 1:1. And there's the finished product. I made the pedestal from a piece of pine I had left over. And those are Lego characters, by the way. Lego figures. I hope you like the way it looks, and look out for more projects. Also, here's a Deadpool project that I recently completed. Just thrown it in there for your enjoyment. Hope you like this one, and see you next time.